Hello everyone and welcome back to Duchess of Success. Christmas is right around the corner and I know that this is a very busy time for everyone, so I hope you're not feeling too stressed. I find that the earlier I get things done and out of the way for Christmas, the less stressed I am and the more that I can enjoy the festive season. So before I get onto today's video, I just wanted to let you know that memberships for Duchess of Success are now live. Do not feel pressured at all if you cannot donate to the channel. I appreciate your presence and you just being here, but there are a number of people who have asked about memberships, so I made them live, and I know that people wanted some other options to donate as well. Just give me a moment while I reset all of my links, and those should be all up running and live properly by Saturday. And don't forget, this Saturday there is going to be a Duchess of Success end of year Sussex Squad party, link in bio to set your reminders for that. But on to today's video. So I believe that the less and less we see of the Queen, the more and more we are going to see of the Middletons. From nowhere, they seem to be everywhere. They were at the Remembrance Festival and they showed up again at the recent Christmas Carol event. The annual Christmas service for the royals has been cancelled, but I'm presuming we would have seen them there as well. And I noticed that a few articles popped up recently about Carol Middleton, because she posted a picture on the Party Pieces Instagram which subtly mentioned her grandchildren, you know, the future heirs. I just get this feeling that they are getting into position for something, and that something, in my opinion, is an all-out takeover of the House of Windsor. There isn't really anyone that can stop them, and who will stop them? Charles? He's already unpopular as king even before he steps foot on the throne. And they have ample material to make his final steps to the throne very, very difficult. It's already happening with the Cash for Honour scandal. I just find it interesting that William doesn't seem to be implicated in this at all or even mentioned, but they somehow decided to try and throw Harry in there as well. Given how easily the Cambridges threw Harry and Meghan under the bus, would it surprise anyone if they threw Charles and Camilla under the bus too? It is so predictable. And the Middletons know which rose bushes William was frolicking around in, so he's not going to be replacing Kate with anyone. And in any case, I don't think the monarchy could survive a divorce if it happened. And here's the thing, Carol Middleton is 66. Let's assume that the Queen lives another 5 years and manages to see 100. She could. And Charles lives another 20 years. So that's 25 years if we're taking an educated guess. Carol would be 91 by the time William comes onto the throne. She's either going to be in a serious state of declining health, or depending on the average lifespan of a Middleton, possibly even deceased. Does anyone really believe that a woman who was ruthless in getting her daughter to be the future King of England's wife wants to risk being at a stage of her life when you're struggling to function independently or not even alive when her daughter is coronated? There is no way she and the rest of the Middleton family are going to risk it. And Kate will be around 65. I don't think she wants to be that age during her coronation. 50 at the most. I think she wants to be coronated before that, if I was guessing. I would bet my entire crypto portfolio that Kate and her mum already have their coronation outfits picked out. They're sketched, fabric swatches are all in a little file somewhere, they know what hairstyles they'll wear, like the whole lot. In a way, I kind of have to hand it to Carol Middleton. I mean, she had all of her children's lives planned out right down to their names. Catherine, James, Philippa, which is Pippa's full name by the way, if you didn't know, it's Philippa. Those are royal sounding names. They're not commoner British names like Mike, Charlie, Ronnie, Bill. I also feel like because of the way the British press, and I think some people in aristo circles, look down on Carol Middleton's working class background, especially during the beginning phases of Kate and William's relationship, she wants to get the last laugh on these people, because despite her daughter being married to the future, they've never really accepted her, and I don't think they ever fully will. But if Kate is Queen Consort, they'll have to accept her by force, because I have no doubt that they will make sure that she is front and center. Another thing that I find incredibly shady, and I think just speaks to what Harry and Meghan had to go through, is that to the best of my knowledge, And please, anybody, do correct me if I'm wrong. Not a single Middleton was seen at Archie's christening. It was closed, so I don't know what the full guest list was. It was a very small group of people though, but I saw nobody from the Middleton side pictured, not even Pippa. But Harry and Meghan showed up to Louis's christening for Kate. There was even a whole Daily Mail article about Meghan blending into the background. I mean, if you have to get some so-called body language expert to do a whole article downplaying someone's presence, that's how you know they were the one who was shining the brightest without trying. I just feel like Karen Middleton got one eyeful of Meghan up close and was like, oh hell no, this girl is not going to upstage my daughter. And I feel that she was part of the smear campaign also. The Middletons have been pretty numb about everything that's happened, and I can just imagine them all googling Meghan when they heard that her and Harry were dating. They saw that UN Women's speech and were like, we have to shut this down. When you consider how supportive and protective Harry was of Kate, more so than William, I feel, you would think the Middletons would have a lot more respect for Harry and would have been a bit more supportive of Meghan, even behind the scenes, but that doesn't seem to have been the case either. Because if Kate knew that the Meghan made Kate cry circus was a lie, that means Karen Middleton and the rest of the Middleton family definitely knew that it was a lie. And I'm convinced that Karen Middleton is furious with the attention Meghan and her children and Harry get, because this was not part of the plan. A smart, accomplished millionaire-ess actress, beautiful biracial duchess just wasn't part of the plan. And I've always felt that they wanted Harry for Pippa. That would have been the cherry on the cake for them. The situation with the Middletons is exactly why aristocratic families typically never married commoners, because you risk a takeover, you risk your aristo secrets getting out and being basically used against you, which is what's happening now. The Middletons were lucky enough to have a bit of inherited wealth through a trust and the money from party pieces. That was enough to get them and their daughters in certain circles. I really want to know how the strings were pulled in order to get Kate so darn close. I mean, reportedly changing her uni, even though she had already been accepted to one that was already top rated, just to be closer to William. Or maybe what we view as a big operation actually wasn't so complicated, because it would appear that no one else was that desperate to get the future. William's exes all seem to have moved on and live in peace. It would appear didn't really want anything to do with the firm. I feel that there's a lot about the Middletons we don't know, and their role in Kate's marriage to William, and how they've been involved in the smear campaign against Meghan. And even if they haven't been directly involved, they have been silent, and one day all of it is going to come out. I am definitely going to be keeping a watchful eye on how they conduct themselves moving forward, and how they conduct themselves after the Queen passes, because I'm utterly convinced that they will make sure that they are front and center. Let me know what you think about that. Do you think I'm wrong? Let's not forget about Kate's uncle Gary over here, who has had some not so nice things to say about the Sussexes. Interestingly, the only Middleton to have spoken publicly about them, and he's done nothing but trash them. That's all for today's video. See you in the next one, my lovelies. And I'll see you on Saturday also. Don't forget, Saturday, come party. Ciao.